Thank you. Anybody recognize that song? Rock and roll. So I think we're gonna slide into something you may not know. It's one of my favorite King Crimson songs. And we're gonna allow the great Mitch Stein to set it up for us. So please give it up. Mitch Stein on guitar.
Thank you.
Wait, please, that translates to. And we've been waiting a long time to play. It's so great to be here. Thank you for coming out. Is everybody enjoying themselves? This is amazing. Beautiful weather. Thank you, Stu and Sparta Arts, for bringing us again. And I'd like to take a second to introduce one of my great friends and one of my favorite bass players to play with, Calvin X Factor Jones. And a little rundown, Calvin. Calvin has played with greats such as Patty Austin, Don Braden, Tom Brown, Alex Bignon, Don Byrd, Steve Coleman, Craig Harris, John Hendricks, Andrew Hill, Jermone Jackson, Eartha Kitt, Dave Koz, Les McCann, Greg Osby, Max Roach, Pharoah Saunders, and James Blood Ulmer. And Calvin had played on the great Broadway show Bringin' the Noise, Ringin' the Funk, and was recently on Jagged Little Pill. And something that's truly sad, because we're finally getting to play together again, is I'm losing Calvin for a year and a half, because he's going out on the road with Hadestown. So you're out there, and if you know this great show, Hadestown, Calvin will be there. So I think Calvin's gonna tee this one up, just do your thing, and I think, feel free to dance and sing along. Here we go. Calvin Jones. Oh, It's such a great honor to be with these people on stage. So let me say it again. Yeah, I'm so grateful to be here. I'm so grateful to be with these wonderful friends, these amazing musicians. So I'm going to give up one at a time. This is the great Mitch Stein on guitar. Somebody say cheese or moose. I heard moose out there. Yeah. There you go. Maybe you've seen Mitch with the Brecker Brothers or Randy Brecker or Bill Evans Soulgrass or I know I did with Tanya Maria, Steve Kimmock, the Herminators, and my favorite on the whole list, Stone Alliance. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. So, next, we're going to take you a little more. This is like my troubled childhood you're hearing because I'm the youngest of four and I had a brother who just force-fed like all that great 60s music to me from age four. He was a drummer. Yeah, so I started really early, and you're listening to the product of that. And I figured this whole, the concept of this group is living standards, so, you know, I hope this is music you like and you've heard and you're here with us. So what are we doing next? We're gonna try another one. I think you should know this. If you know it, there's no prize, but I think you'll take it. Thank you. safe. Thank you. Was that fun? It was fun for us. Looking for my reading glasses. Because, where's my sheet? My special cheat sheet. Because when you have Rachel Z on stage, you need your reading glasses to read her bio. Let's see. So little did I know that Rachel had an opera house as a dollhouse as a kid. I just found that out today. It's very dorky. But I've known Rachel a long time, and it's like some other things. It's only a couple of the people I've known for a long time, you know, that play together a lot, and I actually look at their bio and I go like, wait, I'm playing with them again? Like that person? Like, oh. Like, I thought I did something with my career. So Rachel graduated from the New England Conservatory, which I didn't know. I thought she was a Berkeleyite like me. Oh, sorry. We trawled over there at New England. With a Distinction in Performance Award while working professionally in a Boston area with Bob Moses, hello, Miroslav Vitus, and George Garzon. I don't know if you know those names, but those are icons. And she returned to New York. She toured with the New England Conservatory Schoolmate and, Najee. Wow. Yeah, she wrote that. She wrote Tokyo Blue. Did we meet in the Najee days? Because Charlie Elgart. Yeah. I entered the business with a guy named Charlie Elgart, and he produced the first Najee recording. Interesting. I remember Rachel coming to our house. He came all the way from Boston, right? I do remember that. And she totaled her car. I remember she ordered Chinese food, too. You did. While performing, recording steadily with the classic fusion band Steps Ahead, one of my favorites, she also worked with Al Di Meola, Larry Coryell, special effects, and Angel Bofill, and began a fruitful association with producer and vibraphonist Mick Maneri. Maneri produced her Columbia Records debut, Trust the Universe. Good title. And her connection to saxophonist with, okay, I must have skipped something in my cut and paste, because I forgot to mention Wayne Shorter. That guy. Her connection to saxophonist great Wayne Shorter grew from major influence to blown collaborator over the 2 years she worked on his hit comeback album High Life, for which she built a synthesized orchestral framework to crystallize his musical vision. She also played acoustic piano on the album and was musical director of the tour that followed. The CD won a Grammy for Best Contemporary Jazz Album, hello. She's the spouse of one of my absolute favorite drummers, Omar Hakim, and she has a great group with him, Osmosis. And maybe you heard of this other artist, great artist, that is one of my other favorite artists that she had the great pleasure to work with, Peter Gabriel. So please give it up to Rachel Z. Okay, did I do okay with that?
No wonder we're all tired.
I'm tired because I have Lyme disease. I have a Lyme disease rash like the size of Arkansas on me. So what are we doing? Oh, we're going to do Little Wing. Yeah. So I have two favorite songs in life, Claire de Lune, and this next song that the great Mitch Stein is going to set up. Thank you. Thank you again, Stu, Sparta Arts, Chris, Steve, and everyone that came out. Rachel Z, Calvin X Jones, Mitch Stein. So we play one more quick one? All right, well, thanks for coming, and I hope you have a great summer, and mask up.
3 minutes? It's gonna be a faster tempo then. Thank you.
Thank you again.